In her heart there's a hole, there's a black mark on her soul. In her hands is my heart, and she won't let go till it's gone. Try to breathe, but I can't, cause the air she feeds me is damned. Got a touch like a thorn, cause the girl she's hiding horns. She got blood cold as ice.
You guys asked for it, and well, we had to make this video. What's up guys, Anubhav here. In today's video, we are talking about how you can shoot cinematic videos with nothing but your phone. Also, today's video is a collaboration with a good friend of mine, Shlok from Tech Burner. He makes some really cool tech videos, so his channel link will be in the description below. Be sure to check him out. With that being said, leave a like, subscribe to the channel, and let's get started.
Shooting in manual allows for a lot more control, but before we get started, here are some settings that you should change before we start recording. First of all, check your storage if you have enough. Then make sure you are recording in 1080p 60 frames per second. You guys might have some issues while editing if you record in 4K, so 1080p would be our choice, and I would recommend you guys to use 60 frames per second, because if you go too high, the footage will be a bit more grainy. If you're using a lavalier mic or an external microphone, make sure you have external audio turned on in your application inside which you're recording. And the last thing, make sure your phone is on airplane mode or on silent, because you might have a lot of issues with the recording if you have notifications turned on. Manual settings allow for a lot more customization. You can adjust the focus to take some amazing smooth focusing shots like these, and you should also be adjusting the ISO and the exposure manually so that the footage is not a lot grainy afterwards, and also there is no lighting fluctuation. Many stock cameras have manual controls, but you can use some third-party application like Beacon Camera or Open Camera to record videos in manual mode.
Okay guys, so another thing I want to talk to you guys about is incorporating movement in your shots like this to make your footage look more cinematic, irrespective of the fact of whether you shot it with a phone or with a camera. What happens when you stand in one place and shoot? I mean, I could have easily stood here and made a typical A-roll sequence of me talking to you and the tripod fixed. But what movement allows us to do is create this alternate dimension, well not alternate dimension, another dimension that allows you to really incorporate and make your viewers more attentive to what you're showing on screen. So a simple static movement like this can be made to look like this with just a little bit of movement. So use some movement and your footage will be looking so much better.
Remember, we shot in 60fps while most of the videos are made in 24fps. That is so that we can slow it down afterwards. 24fps gives a lot more cinematic look, and you might not notice, but the eyes can make out automatically. In fact, most movies that you see in Indian cinema or on Hollywood are played back in 24 frames per second. But now you guys might ask, why did we shoot in 60fps in the first place? We did this so we could slow down the clips afterwards. Slowing down makes the clips a lot more smoother, and if done right with manual focusing, they will look just as professional as a tracking shot. Here's how to do that in Premiere Pro. Import your footage in 60 frames per second, the stock footage I mean, then select the speed. Then right-click on the footage and put it as 45 or 50. This will slow down the clips. But you can see the footage is still a bit choppy, so you can right-click and select Optical Flow. Optical Flow will recreate frames and make the footage a lot more smoother. And when you're exporting, make sure the frame rate is set as 24fps. And all of this will make the footage look a lot more cinematic.
The next thing we are talking about is planning your shots and having a kind of a workflow before you actually step out with your camera. A lot of times we think we'll shoot something amazing. It has happened with me, happens to the best of us. We take our phones, we go to a place and just pull our phone out and start shooting random things. Not only does that extend the amount of work that you have to do, but also when you sit to edit, you don't really have any kind of workflow. You don't know what transitions to put where, and irrespective of the fact whether you shot it with a DSLR or a phone, a very cluttered workflow can never lead to something good. So plan your shots ahead. Just take a simple piece of paper or use Google Docs and write down what exactly you want to shoot before you go out and shoot. Different transitions like frame blending or something like masking does require a thought into it before you actually go out to shoot. So think of these things before you go out to shoot, and your film or movie, whether you've shot it from a phone or from a camera, doesn't matter, will end up looking great.
You can use a lot of stuff for your smartphone to make your footage look a bit better. You can have a tripod or a handheld gimbal. These were sent to me by Blitzwolf and they are quite good. They can be used to create macro shots or wide angle shots with a fisheye view, or you could get creative with them and create some artistic shots. These small three are quite good value for money, but this big one that weighs just as much as my smartphone is a bit expensive and I won't recommend this. But the most important thing that you should be investing before spending your money on any of these things is a microphone. Sound can greatly improve the overall feel of your video, and you don't have to buy a very expensive mic. You can get a 200 rupees lavalier microphone that you can plug directly in your mobile. This video has about 100,000 views, and except the intro shots, the whole video is recorded with the 200 rupees lavalier mic, and none of them complained about the quality. So yeah, make sure you do something for the audio. And if you want an upgrade, you can use this Boya microphone that can connect directly into your smartphone or also on your DSLR, but it costs a little more.
Okay guys, so the third tip we're going to be talking about is the power of post-production and how you can use it to make an average looking footage look absolutely stunning. Anything from color grading to adding cinematic bars, as well as taking your footage and slowing it down in post, or changing the way that it looks entirely by either manually adjusting the exposure and the contrast and everything else in general, can really take a clip that looks very amateur like this and turn it into something like this. So don't underestimate editing. Even if your footage does not look that great, as soon as you shoot it, you can turn it into something amazing.
And that is pretty much it, guys. If you guys like the video, you know what to do. Leave a like, subscribe to the channel. Huge shout out to Shlok for being a part of this video. Go check out his channel. I'm sure you guys will love it. With that being said, this is Anubhav signing out, and I will see you guys in my next video.